we know which therapies actually work? Well, very specific guidelines have been put forward, for instance, by the American Psychological Association. According to these guidelines, in order for an intervention to be evidence-based, there need to have been at least 2 independent randomized controlled trials, otherwise known as RCTs, that indicate that the intervention is useful in treating a particular presenting problem. It's important to have at least 2 independent randomized controlled trials. Let's say I write a treatment program for treating anxiety disorders in children, which is one of my areas of interest and expertise. Then I go ahead and publish 5 papers on 5 different RCTs that I've done with my intervention. Potentially, I have a vested interest in trying to show that my intervention works. This is why having 2 separate, independent RCTs is so important. You need to have at least 2 independent RCTs that have been conducted by different groups of researchers and have not all come out of the same research group that potentially has a vested interest in a particular intervention. So that's the first criterion. The second criterion is that the active treatment that you're evaluating has to be better than either a placebo condition or an alternative active treatment. For those who might not be familiar with what a placebo is, the easiest way to think about it is in terms of pharmaceutical trials. Let's pretend we're trialing a new antidepressant medication. We're hoping that this new antidepressant medication will have the effect of improving people's mood. But we also have a placebo condition, in which participants receive a tablet with no active ingredients, often referred to as a sugar pill. People in a pharmaceutical trial, they don't know which condition they've been assigned to, the active medication condition or the placebo condition. They have been randomly assigned to one of the 2 conditions, hence the term randomized controlled trial. For us to be able to say that an intervention is evidence-based, the active intervention we're evaluating has to perform better than the placebo and/or the alternative treatment that we're comparing it against. The final criterion is that the RCT must be competently carried out.